Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. This video has a lot of demonstrations, which can cause mild disorientation. We also include an animation of how the eye works. Viewers who are sensitive to this content should ask someone else to view it first, to be sure that it's suitable for them. For best results, we suggest that you watch this video on a medium-sized computer screen that is about one arm's length away from your eyes. Your eyes should be at the center level of the computer screen. Let's start with an experiment. While focusing on the black dot, slowly move your head towards and away from the computer screen. Do you see any movement in these rings? Many people perceive that the rings are moving in opposite directions. To prove that this image is not animated, we suggest you pause the video and move your head towards and away from the screen again. This is an example of an optical illusion. An optical illusion is when there's a difference between what we see and what is really going on. In science, we try to figure out what's really going on. That means we need to know when we can't trust our eyes, such as during optical illusions. In this video, we'll give examples of optical illusions that make many people see things that are not real, such as those affecting size, straight versus curved lines, imagined data, ignored data, blind spots, shades, color, visual acuity, and brightness. Before we give more examples of illusions, we'll define some terms. The word perception refers to what we initially think is happening based on our senses. In this example, it might seem that this person's hand is almost as big as a tree. The word reality refers to what is actually happening. In this example, we can see that this person's hand is normal size, but his hand is much closer to the camera than to the tree. The word illusion refers to when a perception is different than reality. This example is called the forced perspective optical illusion. Illusions can affect any of our senses. For example, if you've ever eaten room temperature chili peppers, you may have had the perception that they were hot, when in reality, they were room temperature. In this video, we'll only discuss illusions affecting our vision, which are called optical illusions. We'll start by looking at size illusions. Which orange disc is bigger? Many people perceive that the one on the right is bigger. This is an illusion. When we remove the other discs, we can see that in reality the orange discs are the same size. You can pause the video to measure their size if you wish. Here's a drawing of a railroad track. Which yellow bar is wider? To most of us, it seems that the top one is wider than the bottom one. This is an illusion. When we add this blue box, we can see that in reality the bars are the same width. You can also measure this on the screen. Which line do you think is longer? The vertical or the horizontal one? Many people perceive that the vertical one is longer than the horizontal one. This is an illusion. They're equal length. We encourage you to measure this on your screen. These examples tell us that our brains frequently make mistakes when trying to estimate the size of something. When we need to be precise, such as when doing science experiments or any construction, it's best to measure something rather than to just trust our eyes. Next, let's look at straight versus curved lines. Would you say the green squares are in straight or curved lines? Many people perceive that the green squares are on curved lines. This is an illusion. You can hold a ruler up to the screen to confirm that in reality the green squares are in a straight line. If we remove the small black squares, then this removes the illusion. This illusion teaches us that we should use a tool when we have to be sure something is straight or level. Next, we'll look at imagined data. While looking at the center black plus sign, what color do you see where each pink dot disappears? Many people perceive that a green dot appears where each pink dot disappears. This is an illusion. In reality, there is no green in this image. If instead of focusing on the central plus sign, you watch the disappearing dots, then you won't see any green. Next, we'll look at ignored data. Look at the center dot, and as you do, please note if any other dots disappear. Many people perceive that one of the yellow dots disappears momentarily. The disappearing yellow dots is an illusion. In reality, the yellow dots are there of all time. You can confirm this by replaying this section of the video. But this time, sit back from the screen by 10 feet and look at the entire image, rather than focusing on one dot. A very important example of not seeing data that is present is called the blind spot problem. To experience this illusion, please sit back from the screen so that the distance between the screen and your eyes is about 3 times greater than the distance between the letters R and L. Next, cover your right eye with your right hand. Then, with your left eye open, look at the letter L. You may need to move your head slightly closer or farther from the screen until you find the distance where the letter R disappears. You can repeat this for your other eye by covering your left eye with your left hand and using your right eye to look at the letter R. When you do this, you'll notice that the letter L disappears. The illusion is that a letter has disappeared, but in reality it's been there the whole time. This happens because there's a part of our eye which has no receptors for light, so we're blind in that tiny part of the eye. That means we cannot see any light that goes into that spot inside our eyes. For example, the driver in this gray car has blind spots on both sides of this vehicle. Part of the white van is in one of the blind spots. If the driver in the gray car moved into the left lane without first checking for blind spots, then the car and the van would crash. When we learn to drive, we're taught to always look over our shoulders before changing lanes as a way to avoid the blind spot problem. Next, let's look at shade illusions. Which end of this bar is darker? Many people perceive that the right side is darker than the left side. This is an illusion. If we remove the background, we can see that in reality, the bar has the same shade throughout its entire length. Do you think square A or square B is darker? Many people perceive that square A is darker, but this is another shade illusion. In reality, their shades are the same. If we fill in the surrounding squares with the same color as square A and B, then we can easily see that square A and B are the same shade. These shade illusions teach us that we judge a color's shade based on comparing it to the surrounding colors, rather than judging it objectively. Next, let's look at color illusions. Would you say there are more than 3 colors in this image? When we see a rainbow in real life, we're seeing about 400 unique colors of light, although many are so similar to each other that it's hard for us to tell the difference between some of them. But when we're looking at a rainbow on a computer screen, we're seeing color illusions. In reality, our screens have only 3 different LCD color types: red, green, and blue. We call these the primary light colors. Our screens are made of thousands of pixels. Each pixel is much smaller than a square millimeter and has 3 separate primary color lights. We see a red dot like this when the red lights are on, while the green and blue lights are off. We perceive this dot as magenta, but that's an illusion. In reality, the red and blue lights are on, while the green lights are off. Next, we'll look at illusions due to visual acuity. When we look at leaves, we perceive that they have an even amount of green color everywhere. But when we use a microscope, we can see that in reality the green isn't evenly distributed, but instead there are many individual green objects like these chloroplasts. Likewise, many single-celled organisms are too tiny for us to see. Although we can't perceive them without special instruments, in reality, many tiny objects and organisms do exist. Next, we'll introduce illusions due to brightness. We can't look at the sun directly since it's so bright that it could cause blindness. With ordinary video cameras, we get images of the sun like this, so we perceive that the sun is shaped like a smooth sphere. But when NASA uses instruments that can filter the sun's brightness, then we can see that in reality there are huge projections erupting from the sun's surface. On the other brightness extreme, if we look at the sky during the night, without any tools or instruments, then we can perceive only 3,000 stars. So we might incorrectly assume there are about 3,000 stars in the universe. But when we use very powerful telescopes that can detect faint light, we find that in reality there are many billions of stars. Compared with other animals, such as cats and cows, we can't see well at night because our eyes can't perceive dim light. But instead of being able to see dim light well, we're able to see far more colors than cats, cows, and many other animals can. Here's a summary of this topic and some extra information. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. Thanks for your attention.